So in this video, we are going to see the include and require functions in PHP. So what's the use of these include and require? We have already declared a function in some PHP scripts, and we may want to include those PHP scripts in another file. Then we can go for include and require, which means if you are seeing in hash include stdio.h, hash include math.h in C++ and all, where those are our library files. If I want to use some function, say for example, if you use stdio.h, hash include, etc., if you include that, then only a cout, cin statement, all those things will work, because those are all defined in those library functions. Similarly, if I want to use some square root function, then sine, cos function, then I have to definitely include math.h include, because those building functions, those library routines are defined in the math.h. So what does that mean? Already we are using that. The functions which are used can be called in another program, another C++ program, without me to declare them again, redefine the script. So the same way here, PHP, in one program, you might have defined some functions. That functions can be called in another program without defining the whole function. So it's a great thing, because we can, so in such way, we can create modules, small programs, and we can write a one program where we can call all those programs without rewriting the code. And we can use that functions again and again in some other programs. So that is what the main aim of using this include and require. The both will do the same operations, except that include, it generates warning, but still the script will run without any without stopping. It will continue execution. Whereas when you use require, it also include the other the content of a PHP script inside another PHP script. Only thing is, what happens if that particular file is not there, then it generates an error. Whereas here, include will not generate an error. It generates a warning, but continue execution. So we'll see that there are four functions: include, require, and include once and require once. We'll see the difference in all these things. First, we'll see the include. Let us say we are writing a small program called add.php, where we write this function add. We pass two parameters and it returns the added value. Only this thing, these are the statements in this add.php. Now we will write another program called include add or .php. So here, if you see that this function is not declared here, instead we use this function include, then within single quotes we call this file, that is the name of the file, add.php, that we have to call. Then we call the function which we have written there, echo add, the name of the function as we call, along with the parameters. Because here we pass the parameter. When you execute this, it will return the value. See here, we in this is just a small program. I'll show you that. See, add.php is one program, and add include is another program. Where in add include, we use this add.php, which is all the statements in this will be, when during execution, all those statements will be included in this. It will insert. So, and then this value will be executed. We'll see how it executes. So we get the value 13, that is the added value of 9 plus 4. Now, when I say, what is the difference between include once and include? Now I include it again. So two times I have included. So now what happened? See, error, because already it has been, we cannot redeclare, because already it is included by using the include once. Sorry, include. Again, I am using include, means it will show me the error, because already all those statements are included. In this case, if I want to avoid this, then I can give the statement as include once. So even if I call this with include, it will not post any error. See, it doesn't show me the error because it will take only once. Even if I have given again and again include once, it will take only one occurrence and it will execute without any problem. So now what is the, how the require will work? Now I say require, again it do the same thing. But the problem is if it is not present, now I'll show the execution of the statement. No change here. But if the file is not present, say for example, definitely I don't have the file name called add from. Okay, this file is not present. Now we'll see how it executes. See, error. It shows the error. So it stops, it shows the and it stops. So that's the main difference. When you go for include and include it. So here, so these things we have seen, when you use same include, it says that two times this is include, so it will say cannot redeclare and error comes. But when you use include once, only one time it will be included, a multiple occurrence will not have any effect and so it will not give you any error. Whereas require once, if it is not present, then it will stop executing and it will give you the error. That's the main difference between require and require.